is up, everybody? Welcome back to Geeked Week 2023.
It's Geeked Weekend. Woo. We're starting your Saturday right with exclusive news and special previews from Netflix shows, movies, and games.
Today, we've got the latest on the Archies, Sonic Prime, and Scott Pilgrim Takes Off.
That's right, and much more. We've got the first teaser trailer for Damsel, Exploding Kittens, and the long-awaited blooper reel from One Piece.
Join in on the fun and tell us what you're hyped for this week with hashtag Geeked Week on socials. It's time to get geeked!
Woo!
Geeked!
We are kicking off with fantasy, adventure, and Millie Bobby Brown as you have never seen her before. It's time for Damsel. So let me tell you a bit more about this movie. Millie Bobby Brown plays Elodie, who believes she's been married to a perfect prince. Sounds good.
I'd read this story.
But she's thrown into a pit.
No.
Twists and turns.
Maybe where we are here, it looks like.
Exactly, yeah.
Pretty pit-like.
And inside the pit, she discovers she's a sacrifice to appease a bloodthirsty dragon. You never see that coming. She's trying to survive long enough until someone can save her.
Sounds like dating in LA.
She soon realizes that no one is coming, and this damsel must save herself.
This is a riff on some familiar tropes that we have, and I think it's fun for Millie, who of course we all know and love thanks to Stranger Things, getting to do something that continues to subvert female tropes and stories. Yes, we love her as 11.
Enola Holmes as well.
Enola Holmes, and now she's a damsel.
Damsel is a dark fantasy adventure, not your typical fairy tale. This is an action-packed role for Millie Bobby Brown. Here's the cast, look at this. Golden Globe winner Robin Wright and Oscar winner Angela Bassett. What else do you want?
That's all you need to tell me, and I'm in.
Let's see it. Here's the world premiere trailer for Dance.
Run from me, darling. You better run for your life. And each time I see you, I contemplate. Run from me, darling. You better run for your life.
Welcome, princess. For generations, it has been our task to protect our people. So tonight, you join a long line of women who have helped to build this kingdom. The price is dear. But so too the reward.
You better run for your life.
I mean, do I have to say it again? Swords. Millie Bobby Brown with a sword, I'm in.
That's all you need. It's a very simple checklist for you. Does it have a sword?
Yes.
It's in.
This looks epic.
It looks awesome. Yeah. This movie is... all we need for Chancellor is a sword. For me, you get some epic fantasy, you get a sword, you get what looks like a really cool story, but also a very richly designed world, and then you're giving me something different with it. I'm genuinely all in on this.
And what I loved about the trailer is that it teases you up because it doesn't give anything away, so I feel it's great just to watch the film and just dive into that story that feels amazing.
as soon as I saw Robin Wright in a crown, I was like, where is my watch list? Let's add. And then you bring in Angela Bassett looking concerned.
And I saw the look on your face when Nick Robinson popped in there too.
Okay, we know Nick Robinson might be playing that prince. So is he a good guy? I can't wait to find out, but I do love Nick Robinson.
You are predisposed to like Nick Robinson, even if he's the reason that Elodie ends up.
I mean, also, I think the dragon looks so cool, too. Like, again, all these great fantasy elements are really sort of popping in this trailer, so I'm really excited.
You can watch all these exciting things because Denzel is coming to Netflix in 2024.
From Millie Bobby Brown, like you've never seen her before, to Archie, Jughead, Betty, and Veronica, my faves, with a brand new twist, let's talk about the Archies. The Archies is the biggest Netflix title coming from India in 2023. It's also the one I'm most excited about, no joke.
You're a huge fan of Riverdale, which was my gateway drug to the Archie comics, so I'm really excited to see this riff on it.
This movie looks so slick. It's like it's the perfect word to describe it.
Yes.
I'd love to tell you guys about it because I'm so jazzed. Set in the 1960s, The Archies is a musical drama based on the Archie comics, where Indian actors take on the beloved characters. It's an experience bursting with youth, rebellion, friendships, first loves, and everything young adult, which is why I'm into it.
I mean, look, after Swords, after anything made by Greg Berlanti, next thing on my like list of faves are musicals, so this sounds right up my alley as well.
Director Zoya Akhtar has built a beautiful world, an out-and-out Bollywood bop based on the Archie comics. And we're already obsessed with this cast. Let's take a look at them.
Okay. Honey, honey. We are the Archies.
The band's most famous song is
Sugar
Sugar.
No.
Sugar Sugar.
What's the final
What is the one thing that Reggie keeps around with him all the time?
Oh, no, no, no.
Veronica and Betty are rivals on what unimportant matter?
Why does it say unimportant? You said it yourself. No, you've changed it.
In the comics, what is Ethel's nickname?
Dot. What instrument does Jughead play?
Drums.
No, this.
What did you say?
Drums.
What is this?
I thought it was a drum.
He also plays
drums.
I am, but I'm also playing the drums with it.
But what instrument does Jughead play drums?
What does Dilton secretly want to be?
Hedy Lamarr.
No, I know. Athlete of Riverdale.
I'm so athletic.
Look at his build. Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed. And please go watch The Archies on Netflix.
I'll already love this cast. What do you guys think?
I mean, I think it's just fun watching them geek out over not only the movie, The Archies, but the whole Archie comic book universe as well.
Yeah, I do love that they were getting lost in the answers because they did know so much information from the Archie comics that they were like, wait, what is in our movie versus the other one? So I'm with you, Ari. I am obsessed with this cast already.
It's so fun when you see the cast like really having fun with this material. Like, you want to watch the movie.
And you can watch the movie too, because The Archies is coming to Netflix on December 7th. Grab your hamburger. Hum.
Up next, we have a brand new series reveal. Get hyped, everyone, because we can officially confirm that Deadwood Detectives is coming to Netflix, and we have the first exclusive look. Roll it. Oh.
We are the Dead Boy Detective Agency. He's the brains. I'm the brawn. We're ghosts, and we solve mysteries.
Dead Boy Detectives?
It's Aces, right?
It's just a stupid name.
We're pretty bang on detectives.
When we're not hiding from death.
Aww. You see, I've opened a real bag of worms.
Marty! Jesus! I'm trying to threaten some kids.
Wow, I think this might be one of the things I'm most excited about coming down the pike for Netflix next year.
This show was made for you,
yes,
Chancellor,
it was.
I'm pretty sure.
And I guess let me just tell you all a bit more about this show. So basically, here's the essential premise. Do you have a pesky ghost haunting you?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, that's problematic.
Okay, I'm concerned. I think I'm fine.
Has a demon stole your core memories?
Every day.
Well then, both of you may want to ring the Deadwood Detectives. As we just saw, we have Edwin Payne and Charles Rowland, the brains and the brawn behind Deadwood Detective Agency. They were teenagers born decades apart who find each other only in death. They are best friends and ghosts who just happen to solve mysteries. And they will do anything to stick together, including escaping evil witches, hell, and death herself. With the help of a clairvoyant named Crystal and her friend Nico, they are able to crack some of the Mortal Realm's most mystifying paranormal cases.
And apparently have fun and look great while doing it.
I mean, can I tell you a little bit about this creative team? It's based on a comic book illustrated by Matt Wagner and Malcolm Jones III. And Neil Gaiman created the characters as part of the Sandman universe. The executive producer is Greg Berlanti, who's done Riverdale, one of my faves, The Flash, and you. And the showrunners are Steve Yockey of The Flight Attendant and Beth Schwartz from Arrow, your literal fave.
It's worth noting that Steve Yockey, before The Flight Attendant, he was also a writer on Supernatural. So again, this feels right in his wheelhouse as well.
In my wheelhouse.
Dead Boy Detectives comes to Netflix in 2024. Our next series is a brand new action thriller from...
Wait, I've just been informed that sound means that we have a message from our sponsors?
I didn't know we had sponsors.
I have a funny feeling about this.
We've got the perfect scoop for you.
Ooh. One scoop.
Two scoops. 11 scoops.
There's no wrong way to scoop. Scoops Ahoy. Scoop your own at home. An ocean of joy with Scoops Ahoy.
Mm-mm. This is certainly the tastiest news we've had all week.
Yum. Wonderful.
What flavors did you guys pick?
I got triple decker extravaganza.
I got the USS butterscotch. This is like caramel, chocolate, vanilla.
You haven't stopped eating that since I saw it in your
hand.
And
I won't stop.
And pineapple it. Upside down.
I get it.
I get that.
Oh, and this is chocolate pudding? And I don't know, but I just got an extra delicious bite, guys.
Would you guys like to set sail on this ocean of flavor with us?
Because you can. Get out there and try all 7 delicious Scoops Ahoy signature flavors exclusively at Walmart.
Wait, what just happened?
Up next, it's Sonic Prime Chapter 3. New episodes of Sonic Prime are on the way. The adventures of the Blue Blur continue as Sonic races to save not just Green Hill, but the entire Shatterverse. To save the day, he'll need to even team up with his rival, Shadow. The stakes have never been higher.
I'm very excited. I love this background. It takes me back when I played the first one in Sega Genesis.
I played Sonic at the orthodontist.
Explain more, please.
Yes. Hey. There was a setup, and that's what they would do to trick you into being fine with your teeth.
I love the evolution of Sonic in Sonic Prime. We're seeing all these new characters. We're playing around in the Shatterverse.
We've come so far. I mean, Sonic's movies, games, now this show.
What's next? I don't know, but here's a new look at Sonic Prime.
This isn't you, Nine. We're friends. We can still figure out how to bring back Green Hill and stabilize the Shatter Spaces together.
You were only using me to get what you wanted.
That's not true.
Sorry, old friend. You've been replaced.
Who or what is that?
It's you.
Yeah, but if you squint and tilt your head to the side, it's also kind of you.
Whatever it is, it's in our way.
Not for long. Again? I already beat one of these things. In New York, remember?
I saved you from the one in New York. This time, you're on your own.
He's not on his own.
We're all on our own.
Over Nine.
That guy got beat up.
That fight scene was really cool, honestly, and I love getting to see Sonic and Shadow team up together, even kind of the meta commentary when they're like, it could be me, but it could be you too. Ah, yes, your character design is the same.
I also really love the meta exhaustion of like, I thought I beat this level already.
Yeah, it's just fast kicks and punches. That's what I like about Sonic. Everything's fast.
Well, Sonic Prime Chapter 3 is speeding to Netflix on January 11th, 2024.
That's soon. Stay tuned, Straw Hats. The official One Piece blooper reel is coming up real soon. If you like scary games, Netflix, and a healthy dose of camp, you're gonna love our next game. It's Slay Away Camp 2, Netflix and Kill. It's included in the Netflix membership you already have.
Also, just the name alone, it's just such a punny name, and I love it.
Yes, this is like, it's like cozy horror.
Yeah.
Spooky season never ends.
Nope.
And we have an exclusive trailer to check out right now. Here's Slay Away Camp 2, Netflix and Kill. So cute. What did you guys think?
I mean, those blockheads are so murdery, you know? Like, there was so much blood.
Cute and bloody. I don't know if those mix, but in this game, they match.
Well, listen, Netflix and Chill was so 2010s. It's all about Netflix and Kill now.
That's it.
and 36 new killers.
Which one would you choose?
Plague Doctor.
Okay, that's what I was gonna say.
You can play this game right now. All you have to do is open the Netflix mobile app to install and play Slay Away Camp 2, Netflix and Kill. Happy slaying.
Slay. Speaking of deadly meets adorable, it's time to take a look at Exploding Kittens. That's right, the best-selling card game is coming to Netflix as a brand new animated series. Has anyone played Exploding Kittens, the game?
I get way too aggressive about it.
I know this about you.
But I have a lot of fire in my astrology chart, so that's what happens.
Yeah. Makes sense.
I have never played the game, but I'm perplexed because that name is just like, it drew me in.
It is exactly what you think it would be and more. Here is our first look at the new series, Exploding Kittens.
It's go time. Good versus evil. You're not gonna believe this. I may look like a cat, but I'm actually God trapped in this body. I made the most exquisite planet of all time. Sunsets, tutors,
Florida.
You know my hits, but humans did get one thing right. This game.
I'd be jambalaying if I said I wasn't having a good day with you.
You know what, Swamp Rat? I'd be jambalaying too. Yippee-ki-yay, mother...
We invented all this natural wonder. Look at this busy little bee. I gave them swords for butts.
As Lord Satan, I command you to open this enchanted robot wall.
What did we just see, everyone?
Tom Ellis is Godcat, which is all you needed to sell me on this show. I mean, as someone who loves Lucifer, like that was enough of a selling point for this.
The man has range. Yes. He can be the devil, and he can be God,
cat.
And a cat.
And I'd follow him either way.
Yeah. Look, the animation is great, and again, Tom Ellis. It's like, to me, it's a surprise just to see him now, like, doing this voice. It's amazing. This is great.
This will definitely scratch that Lucifer itch for everyone who's missing that. When you see that pedigree from the creators of The Office, Beavis and Butthead, and King of the Hill, yeah, it comes across.
You know the type of comedy
you know
get.
What you're into. You know
for
what you're
sure.
into. There's also an expansion pack for the card game, Exploding Kittens Good versus Evil. So grab your Godcat, Ari, and go win game night. I know you will. I believe in
I'm
you.
Ready.
I believe in you. Exploding Kittens comes to Netflix in 2024.
Up next, a highly anticipated animated video game adaptation, Devil May Cry. I know everyone's freaking out about this.
Yes, we just got our first look at the series a couple months ago during Drop 01, and the internet was hungry for Dante.
Oh yeah, Dante is one of my favorite characters of all time when it comes to video games.
I mean, it makes sense. Adi Shankar is behind this. He also did Captain Laserhawk, so he knows a thing or two about video games.
For sure. And I'm also so excited to hear that Studio Mir is the animation studio behind this. We obviously saw a little bit from them with Witcher Sirens of the Deep yesterday. I love all the stuff they've worked on. They also actually did Dota Dragon's Blood for Netflix as well.
And we have a very special Geek Week message from creator Adi Shankar. Let's take a look.
I'm Adi Shankar, executive producer, showrunner, and creator of the upcoming Devil May Cry series that will be exclusively available on Netflix. Since I announced this show in 2018, I've been hearing you guys. Adi, what's taking so long? Did you lose interest in Devil May Cry? Do you not think Dante's cool anymore? So let me set the record straight. My development partner, Alex Larson, and I, we've been working on this show every day since 2018. Our goal wasn't just to pump out another animated show. My goal is to make one of the best shows on the Netflix platform period. We had awesome partners in Studio Mir. They are one of, if not the best animation studio out there that does this type of work. Their portfolio of hit after hit after hit speaks for itself. Part of me wants to make jokes about cosplaying as Dante and like waking up dressed as Dante and stuff like that. But there's a sincere aspect to this also, which is like when you deeply care about something and then all of a sudden now you find yourself at the helm of it. Cool. More importantly, when you get to work with amazing collaborators like Alex Larson, like Studio Mir, like Netflix, who have been pioneers in this adult animation streaming space. So rest assured, we're working very hard because we love the franchise and because we want to deliver something great, something that stands the test of time. And I'm going to get back to work, but get hyped.
So this is what it's about. After losing their family, a demon hunter embarks on a quest to confront the evil Lord Mundus.
And of course, our hero is Dante. It was great to see some new shots of him in there. I know, again, people were losing their minds when we saw him and his double pistols back in that Droppo 1 tease.
I'll be honest, I don't know anything about this franchise, but I'm invested now just because of Addy's enthusiasm about this project.
To me, like Devil May Cry, it's such a like a go back to the first. It was one of the first hack and slash that I played. So, you know, I just remember myself just dragging into that world and knowing Dante and all these years with all these new things that have come up. So, you know, it's like, you know, every time he comes out, it's like, oh, the old pal that you know, meet again. So I'm excited.
Lisandro, we're all excited. So be sure to follow Netflix Geek for the latest updates on Devil May Cry.
Coming up soon, a never-before-seen One Piece blooper reel. Then, the latest on Scott Pilgrim takes off and a new Korean show that I am very excited to share with all of you.
It's time to reveal an incredible new anime coming exclusively to Netflix. We have your first look announcement right here.
That's right, Netflix is making a brand new anime based on Terminator, and you heard it first on Geek Week.
I love the Terminator universe, I'm a huge fan. I love that we're getting an anime coming into advance the story, so let me tell you all a little bit about it. In August 1997...
Like in all the movies.
Of course, in a very important year, a computer scientist named Malcolm Lee is working furiously from his lab in Tokyo to launch an AI program he believes will save the world.
AI, what could go wrong?
As the course of the future changes from the past, an unrelenting assassin is sent back in time to murder Malcolm and his three children in order to ensure its future dominance over humanity.
What a surprise on that Terminator thing.
What a surprise. Presumably, this assassin may be a
Terminator.
Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. The assassin is followed through time by a lone soldier who will do anything to keep Malcolm and his family alive in order to prove once and for all, there is no fate.
We love nihilism.
What's great about the Terminator franchise is that if you're a fan, if you watch the first and you continue watching, there's always like snippets and like Easter eggs that you can catch. So I feel that this anime is gonna be filled with those.
I really think this is something that the fans who have invested so much time, so much energy, are going to love.
I think it's also cool that it comes from Production IG, who are sort of the renowned Japanese anime studio behind Ghost in the Shell.
And it's crazy that there hasn't been a Terminator anime up until now. It really, even though it's a Western franchise, I feel like it's so ripe for that kind of adaptation. And to the comparison of Ghost in the Shell, there's a lot of parallels that could be made in between that.
Stay up to date with Terminator by following us at Netflix Geek. Hasta la vista.
Up next, we've got what's already considered to be one of the greatest games of all time. We are so excited to reveal that Hades is coming to iOS exclusively for Netflix members. If I wasn't geeked enough already, let's get even more geeked and watch the gameplay trailer for Hades.
I'm leaving. Try and stop me.
First get past the wretched shades of Tartarus. The river of flame ought to be just beyond. Find a way up to Elysium from there, and after that... How hard could it be? That's what you get.
I played so much of this game on multiple different platforms, and I'm very excited that it is coming to mobile as well. I keep talking to you guys about how hot everyone is, how fun it is to play, what a good story it is, but let me tell you a little bit about what Hades the game is all about. It is a roguelike dungeon crawler from developer Supergiant Games. Again, one of the best game studios working right now. Bastion, shout out. You play as the character Zagreus, who is the son of Hades. The plot centers around Zagreus attempting to escape the underworld after learning that he had an unknown family, the Olympian gods, on Mount Olympus, who are eager to meet him. And so you keep playing the game, trying to escape the underworld, and it really rewards you with many different story paths and dialogue paths and characters, and I love this. I don't know if you know this, but I love this game so much. This is very exciting.
I mean, look, as I've said many times this Geek Week, I love swords, love any game with swords. I mean, that looks so cool. I love how the action and combat looks. I mean, all the options, and just, I guess, the whole idea of also just having to, like, play through it, die, go back to the beginning, and being to take what you learned and use that to progress even further. I think that is just such a cool way to build a game.
I think that my thumbs are gonna hurt after playing this game, because this is just, it's ridiculous. Like, I don't know how this guy does this, but my thumbs are gonna be tired.
Yes. Yeah. Well, start training. Like, start training.
Stretch.
Work out now.
You told me Zag was sexy, and he lived up to the hype. He might have even exceeded the hype. And all of a sudden, I understand why this is called one of the greatest games of all time.
You don't need to air quote it, okay? The attractive characters are not,
but they certainly help.
I will say, you know, we talked a lot about Blood of Zeus this week. I feel like Hades is a really good pairing with that too, if you want that Greek mythology to be scratched.
I was a big Greek mythology girly growing up, and as soon as you tell me someone's hot, I'm interested. So maybe I'm gonna play.
Well, you won't have too long to wait, because Hades will be released officially on Netflix next year in 2024, and you are getting it as part of the Netflix membership you already have. It's already on your phone. Not Hades yet, but soon. This will be the only way to play Hades on iOS, so download the Netflix mobile app now to get ready. Speaking of some of the greatest games ever made, we have another critically acclaimed game finally coming to mobile exclusively for Netflix, Braid Anniversary Edition. This game was already stunning, but for Braid Anniversary Edition, the game art was completely repainted in higher detail for modern devices. And there are newly recorded commentary tracks made by the original team behind Braid, going over all the groundbreaking puzzles and moments of the game. Let's take a look at the trailer for Braid Anniversary Edition.
Thank you.
you said before the trailer how beautiful it looks, and I mean, this new version is stunning.
I cannot stress enough at how good the backgrounds are.
Like, especially the updated ones.
Yeah, it feels like a dreamy painting version of your dreams, and yeah, it's amazing how it looks.
It looks like a living painting.
There you go.
I mean, sort of like the Blue-Eyed Samurai featurette from yesterday, with where they showed us how they made, sort of where they filmed live-action fighters doing the stunts to then animate that to make it more accurate, and just sort of the detail that we got with that. I'm looking forward to playing this game with the commentary to sort of find out how they made this, you know.
What I love about Braid is it's also, in addition to being beautiful as well, it's got this really good story, and I think it really rewards you paying attention as you get through it.
I'm so curious, what is this about?
So I don't want to give too much away because, again, it really rewards you when you sit down and you play it for yourself. But you are essentially trying to rescue a princess, and you're progressing through this fantasy world and trying to solve puzzles and picking up clues along the way. But I think the thing that makes Braid really unique is that you have the ability to move back and forward through time. And so you need to be able to kind of forward progress and rewind yourself in order to solve the puzzles. So when you see kind of your character moving backwards and forwards in some of the gameplay, that's what you're playing around with. And it's very clever. I love this game.
That's amazing. So if you make a mistake, you can go back, or it's just because you need to solve the puzzle?
Well, I guess you're just gonna have to play to find out, Lizandro. Braid Anniversary Edition will be available to play soon as part of your Netflix membership.
One Piece took the world by storm when the Netflix live action came out in August. We saw a whole lot of love for the Straw Hat crew and a surprising and maybe troubling amount of fan cams for Buggy. Okay, so here's a TLDR if somehow you have not watched One Piece yet. In a seafaring world, a young pirate sets out with his crew to attain the title of Pirate King and to discover the mythical treasure known as One Piece.
And we're on the Baratie right now, which is pretty great because I'm getting hungry, and I hear there's a pretty good chef who works here.
I have a question for you all out there. Mm-hmm. Why do you love Buggy so much?
We've seen your TikToks.
It's crazy. It's real, like the love that this cast is and the characters are getting.
It's Jeff Ward. I mean, I get it, you know.
Actually, the cast is so stacked top to bottom. Iñaki Godoy just won my heart over before I even saw him as Luffy. And then you see him and you can't imagine that character played by anyone else.
That's
you
true.
Have Emily Rudd, McKenyu, Taz Skyler, Jacob Romero. The Straw Hat Pirates could not have been more perfectly cast.
I love when a cast comes together and it's so clear that they are close.
And they love One Piece. Like, you can feel how much they love this show and they put their heart and soul into it.
The fandom is honest.
Oh, yeah. You can see it with all those TikToks out there.
Well, we couldn't let a Geek Tweet go by without an update from our favorite Straw Hats. While season 2 was still far off on the horizon, we do have a special gum gum treat for you. Season 1 bloopers.
This is a world like no other, one teeming with danger. The world of pirates.
Oops, sorry.
Pirates. Pirates, for those who don't understand.
It's close-up time.
Oh, my bad, that was me.
It's gonna be a few of these, and I apologize in advance.
One moment. I forgot my line.
Yep. And then you're doing another one? Bigger mouth as well. Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Man, I love acting.
Wow! Yes, aren't you listening? I can't stop crying.
Sorry. Do you mind if I start again?
You're just a sad, lonely little boy who's wearing a... You're just a sad, lonely boy who always loses at FIFA.
Sorry. I was just helping him with the performance. Sorry. Okay.
Yeah!
My notes calling you here.
What? Sorry, I ate too much. I can't swallow this.
Nice.
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 Let's do it one more time.
Okay.
I think we can definitely say that was very nice.
I want to be friends with every single one of the cast members of this show. They're fantastic.
Honestly, it's so hard to pick a favorite blooper out of there. I will say I'm a sucker for narration bloopers, so I love that we got a little bit bonus from Ian McShane as the narrator there, iconic voice.
Pirates.
Pirates.
I think my favorite was definitely Jeff Ward's FIFA comment.
Or like Buggy's head falling out. Really just anything with Buggy. We now have more Buggy material to be obsessed with.
We know I love smooches, and we know that I'm a shipper, so that awkward kiss really got me.
Unlike Lorne Michaels, I love it when people break. So, And especially seeing the villains break in this blooper reel, priceless.
I love the bite with Arlong, just, you know, the nose tucking like the hair. Yeah, it's so cool. I want to watch it again.
As someone whose hair gets caught in everything, it felt very relatable.
It's also funny, we see the finished product of so many of these performances, but hearing their actual voices and how different they are. I will say that music, that theme gets me hyped every time, so I know that is not a blooper. Yeah, I am ready for more. It just jazzes me up.
Well, please make sure you follow at Netflix Geeked and at One Piece Netflix for all the latest updates on One Piece.
Aye, aye, Captain. Aye, aye.
When it was announced that Netflix would be getting the band back together, the internet exploded. This is Scott Pilgrim Takes Off.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm ready to rock.
I love Scott Pilgrim so much. I remember I saw Save the World in theaters, and the second this title was announced with the full voice cast back and Edgar Wright involved again and Brian Lee O'Malley, I'm so excited to return to this world. It's become such a cult favorite.
And watch it like animated now. It's such a weird but fun way to see it that it's so refreshing. And again, it's kind of like going back to that first time I watched the movie. It's amazing.
I'd love to tell you about this for all the fans and people coming to this title for the first time. Scott Pilgrim meets the girl of his dreams, Ramona Flowers.
Of course.
Icon. But learns he must defeat her 7 evil exes in order to date her. Then things get even more complicated, based on the graphic novels by Brian Lee O'Malley.
I mean, I'm just excited for this voice cast. Michael Cera, Mary Elizabeth Winstead, Ellen Wong, Satya Baba, Johnny Simmons, and Kieran Culkin.
The power.
So we're reuniting the all-star cast from the movie, but it's not the same story you already know. We're going to see a very different side of these characters and their stories. So let's take a look.
Take my hand.
The girl of my dreams?
Wanna go out sometime?
You wanna go on a date? With me?
You like him, don't you?
There were sparks.
You went on one date. How good could it have been?
Honestly, great. Ha!
I love a love story, as all of you know I won't shut up about. So I'm super energized right now. What did you guys think?
I mean, I love a remix.
And I love the new logo. I think that, you know, it's very 8-bit. It kind of gels with the animated version of it all. So I love how this thing is crafting up.
Well, I'm really excited to see what the takes off part of Scott Pilgrim Takes Off means.
And to me, I'm very curious to see how the animation, because there's some things that you cannot do in live action. So I'm very curious to see how they bring Scott Pilgrim into, you know, places that you can't in film.
I'm looking forward to this voice cast.
They're somehow all back. I don't know what witchcraft Edgar Wright did, but I'm so excited.
I mean, either way,
you
gotta thank the scheduling gods.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Scheduling gods, we have so much
so who are you guys most excited to see come back?
I am just hoping, and I don't know if this is gonna happen or not, genuinely, did we get another Brie Larson musical performance? Ooh. Fingers crossed.
Fingers
Black
crossed.
Sheep still remains. I mean, I revisit it on YouTube often.
And I heard Aubrey Plaza in there too, so there's so much to look forward to.
I cannot wait. Scott Pilgrim takes off November 17th.
If you loved All of Us Are Dead and Squid Game, get ready for Kyungsung Creature.
Set in early 1945 in colonial Korea, two young adults encounter a strange creature born of greed and battle for survival in the city of Kyungsung.
And Kyungsung, I don't know if you know this, is the old name for Seoul, the capital of South Korea.
I didn't know that.
And I'm very excited because it has creatures, you know?
I mean, listen, you love a creature feature, so I'm very excited to see what this one has.
Not only do we have a sneak peek at Kyungsung Creature, but Geeked Week can exclusively reveal the release date. Check it out.
안녕하세요. 죽은 사람도 찾아낸다는 소문난 토토끈 윤채욱 역을 맡은 한소희라고 합니다.
이번 긱드 위크를 통해서 드디어 경성 크리처의 공개일이 발표되었는데요. 기대되지 않으세요?
네, 너무 기대가 되는데요. 어서 빨리 저희의 이 격동적인 이야기를 팬분들과 나누고 싶습니다.
과연 저 장태상과
윤채욱은
탐욕 위에 태어나 경성을 뒤흔든 괴물들,
그리고 그런 괴물들보다도 더 괴물 같은 사람들과 어떻게 맞서 싸우고 또 어떤 호흡을 보여줄지,
곧 다가올 12월 22일 쓸쓸한 어둠이 드리웠던 비극의 시대이자 뜨거운 대결이 펼쳐질 1945년 경성에 여러분을 초대합니다.
끝까지 많은 기대와 관심과 사랑 부탁드립니다.
I think it's fair to say that all of us up here are sort of fans of Supernatural series,
yes,
especially
yes.
period ones, right?
Yes, 100%.
Yeah.
And I mean, I think after watching that video, I'm also just excited to see those two working together. I love a dynamic duo at the center of a story as well.
I want to see their chemistry, and also in that teaser, you see them like running.
Yeah.
They're escaping, attacking. You sense that it's going to be all about, oh my God, these creatures, you know?
I'm already getting big Jaws vibes. I'm like, I can't wait to see this creature. I'm afraid to see this creature. We're going to be thrilled. We've been hanging out for a couple days, so you know I'm a shipper. As soon as I see these two, I don't know, but I'm like, two friends, maybe they're gonna kiss? Fingers crossed.
Liz is over here rooting for the creature. You're yeah. over here rooting for the kissing.
Yes.
Maybe the next one is season two, creatures kissing.
I would love creatures kissing.
Well, you heard it here first. Kyungsung Creature is coming to Netflix on December 22nd. That was awesome, but Geeked Week is far from over.
That's right, we've still got Rebel Moon, and tomorrow we will have the world premiere of the brand new trailer.
And that's not all. Director Zack Snyder will be here to join us for a fan Q&A.
To hold you over until then, here's a Geeked Week sneak peek at Rebel Moon. Roll it!
That looks awesome.
Just, oh my God, just wow.
That cast.
Can't wait for tomorrow.
I know we have questions, and so do you.
Well, tomorrow we'll be getting all the answers from Zack Snyder himself.
In the meantime, check out todoom.com, where you can dive into all of this week's films, games, and series.
And we'll see you tomorrow for Rebel Moon Day.